my blood pressure spiked. I was on bed rest, so it was just trying to keep the risk of anything serious happening to a minimum. And last year, kind of ran out of medication to try, and they offered this option.
High blood pressure is a condition which sometimes doesn't cause symptoms, but has a consequence in that it causes an increased risk of stroke, increased risk of heart attack, and ultimately that impairs both how long we might live, but also how well we might live in the future.
So in terms of the different medications, either they weren't doing anything or they were giving me side effects in terms of significant joint swelling or changes to my pulse rate and that side of things. Nothing really controlled my blood pressure effectively enough.
So one of the principles of treating blood pressure is to lower the blood pressure safely and effectively, but not cause symptoms. And one of the problems we have for some people is that they can't find a drug which doesn't make them feel less well.
They said there was a new procedure that they were trialling, and then I had a 6-month follow-up, and they said, actually, my options are starting to get a little bit limited, and my blood pressure is still in more of a dangerous category more often than not. And so they suggested trying this.
Renal denervation is a new available therapy for patients with resistant hypertension, which means high blood pressure that is not responding to medical therapy, or a patient that can take medication for blood pressure but they're getting severe side effects from it.
When I looked at it and I looked at studies across the world, and it's had quite positive outcomes, and certainly there wasn't that many negative outcomes from it. So I think that's what made me kind of go, well, yes, it's a slightly different option. It's a slightly different procedure than some of the other ones, some of the other papers, but it was close enough for me to think, if they're happy to have me and they're happy to do it, I'll give it a go.
Usually we say that 80% of individuals have a good response, so have a drop in blood pressure of at least 10 millimeters of mercury.
Obviously, the ideal world would be a nice normalized blood pressure, nice and stable, but I do realize that that's not what they're aiming for. They're aiming for an improvement, not a cure.
We'll basically explain in simple language what the renal denervation procedure will be. Then we follow up with a phone call and we see if it's that something that you'll be interested in. If you've got any clinical questions, we put you in contact with the consultant, and then he will be able to answer any other questions that you might have about the procedure.
In terms of risks, this is a procedure that is relatively straightforward. In that regard, there is a fair amount of benefit that we can provide, especially if you are in that 80% range of responders. And the risk to face upfront is trivial, or definitely smaller if you compare to the risk that you would put yourself if you're going to need a heart procedure 5-10 years down the line.
The objective risks weren't that high of serious consequences, just because of how they were doing the procedure, how they were going in. It's a fairly known route.
So we will provide you with advice of healthy lifestyles, and then we kind of like look through what it could be the cause of your hypertension. It may be a stress, or we help you with your mental health and well-being to try to make the procedure as successful as possible.
We are advocating this treatment as not as a standalone, but as a part of a bigger package with lifestyle measures, medications, with the ultimate aim not to stop the medications, I repeat that, but to keep the blood pressure under control, because the benefit is going to be 10, 20 years down the line when your risk of a stroke or a heart attack is going to be less.
I'd asked everything that I could think of. They'd explained it very well as far as I was concerned. They gave me lots of opportunities to ask questions. They were available by email, by phone, and obviously I saw them in person as well.
The kidney themselves are controlled from the brain. The kidney and the brain are in constant interaction and communication through nerves. So renal denervation means that what we can do, we can interrupt this crosstalk, because in patients with high blood pressure, the kidneys are getting the wrong message that the blood pressure is normal or low, and then as a consequence, they're trying to keep it up, despite actually that's not the case. And then we can deliver a form of energy, which can be either ultrasound or radio frequency energy, and pretty much we are heating the tissue around the renal artery that contains the nerves, and then as a consequence the nerves get disconnected and this crosstalk between the brain and the kidney actually gets neutralized in a way.
This procedure is either done from an artery in the wrist or more commonly an artery in the leg, and we make the patient drowsy, so most patients aren't really aware of what's going on from there on in. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put, once the anaesthetic's in, I'm going to put a little needle into the artery, get inside the artery and steer a little tube round to the kidney arteries, and then I can put the special catheters down that tube to deliver the energy into the wall of the vessel. The procedure usually lasts 45 minutes to an hour.
I don't remember any of the procedure. I know it's quite light in terms of the anaesthetic they give you.
We know that the nerves run on the outside of the vessel. Clearly our tube is inside the vessel, but we spend a lot of time working out how we can deliver that energy to the outside of the vessel without damaging the lining of the vessel. So we're very careful to measure the temperature. The catheters are specially designed to do that. And we work out how to deliver the maximum energy with the minimum risk to the inside of the vessel of the kidney artery.
I remember them waking me up, telling me it had gone well. And then they wheeled me background to recovery.
Ultimately, what this is about is investing a short period of time, a day or 2 days in hospital, for what might be hopefully many years of good quality life.
Post-procedure, I remember the nurses making me keep my leg quite nice and flat. You're kept quite limited for, it's only a few hours, but if you need to pee or anything, you're not allowed to stand. After, you know, I'd come around properly and things, I was wheeled over to a separate room. And I think I had something to eat and drink at that point when I was in the room. They checked your blood pressure. They just checked, you know, how you're feeling, that, you know, significant side effects. And then you're able to stand, you're able to kind of toilet yourself properly and everything. And then was discharged, walked out of the hospital.
After the procedure, take it easy, take it slowly, try not to do like so much heavy lifting. And then with any concern, you always have to contact us and then we will give you advice on what you should do or shouldn't do. So if in any doubt, it's better to ask.
I would always say be a little bit more relaxed about how your body is doing, listen to yourself and just take it at your own pace.
What we don't want to do is to put patients at risk of having high blood pressure while the effect of this treatment is starting to accrue. So I think it's unrealistic to expect you're going to stop all your tablets with this treatment. It's likely you're going to need some. What we're after is getting your blood pressure control to be better. And that's a key point.
Just keep in mind that by reducing your blood pressure by only 10 millimeters of mercury, you're reducing your risk of stroke and heart attack by 25%.
They have encouraged me not to check my blood pressure very often. It can still be quite fluctuant in the early months after procedure. And you don't want to give yourself kind of false hope or give yourself more concerns. But generally, I think it's looking positive. Certainly, my 3-month review was positive.
It's not going to replace good lifestyle changes. It's not going to replace medication. It's going to work in synergy with the other two major solutions that we have to control high blood pressure. It is good to know as a clinician that we have alternative or additional option that we can offer to the patients.
What we see is that most patients respond in some way to this. There are some patients who respond fantastically and they respond very quickly, and there are other patients who respond more slowly and perhaps less fully. I think it's likely that when we look back in 5-10 years time, we'll be clear about who it's likely to work best for, but at the moment we're still working on that, and that's part of the ongoing research that we're doing.
I've been swimming, I've gone back to the gym and just generally building up my fitness again, and certainly compared to how things were before the procedure, I've certainly had more energy to do things, and it's been possible again.